Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. Before I go into the analysis of what happened in the previous period and what is to come in the next period, I would like to address what I've seen in the last couple of days. A lot of rumors, even misinformation, false information, where it has been stated that there will be a big quake in Morocco again from the 19th to the 21st. I've seen it in newspapers even. This is, of course, not correct. I've even seen claims that there will be a tsunami this week. I didn't say anything of the sort in the previous update. You have to keep in mind that every update video has two parts. The first part is about what happened, and that can be put in a historical context. Like I did with the Morocco earthquake, I put that in a historical context. The second part is the forecast, that is the analysis of the planetary geometry that we will have in the coming 8-9 days. Okay, they are not directly related. So nowhere in the previous update did I say that there will be a tsunami or a big quake in Morocco or off the coast of Portugal. So if you come across rumors in social media or you read something in the media, newspapers, always check out the official source, that is our website and our social media channels. There you will find the correct information. And this is very important because rumors and false information can be really damaging. Okay, so let's see what we had in the previous period since the 12th of September. We see clustering of stronger earthquakes. The strongest earthquake was magnitude 6.3 northeast of Taiwan, and that happened on the 18th. And I put emphasis on 19, 20 and 21 September. And as you can see, we have a pretty strong clustering of stronger earthquakes. It is actually the strongest clustering since 8 September. And this is what you can expect with critical planetary geometry. A convergence of planetary conjunctions like we had on the 19th. It was followed by a clustering of strong earthquakes, multiple earthquakes approaching or even exceeding magnitude 6. And this is pretty much expected, okay? Other than that, we didn't have a larger earthquake, nothing approaching magnitude 7, although I do believe that there was the potential for such a larger earthquake around the 20th. Okay, so what are we going to have in the coming time up until the 30th of September? Actually, not really much. We only have three planetary conjunctions coming up, and that will be on the 22nd. That's actually later today. Mars, Mercury, and Jupiter in a conjunction. There can be some stronger seismic activity as a result, probably not much in the days following that conjunction. Probably a bit more critical will be from 26, 27 to the 28th of September, because there we see a Venus-Sun-Mars conjunction that will be later on the 25th, and it will actually be followed by a clustering or a convergence of some critical planetary geometry. These are the dashed and dotted peaks, red and purple, on 26, 27 and 28 September. And it will converge with lunar geometry, in particular Earth, Moon and Saturn. And that will be early on the 27th. And you can also see that the lunar conjunctions in the coming period will primarily be later on the Moon conjunction with Neptune and also the full Moon on the 29th. And then the conjunction with Mars, and it will be on the 30th. And at the end, we see another planetary conjunction that will be Sun, Venus, and Jupiter. But I will cover that also in the next update. So overall, I don't think that there will be really big seismic activity. The typical clustering of stronger earthquakes following the critical geometry, especially from the 26th to the 28th of September. If we look at atmospheric fluctuations, again, we didn't record all that much. We did see some unrest in the atmosphere, and we had these stronger earthquakes approaching magnitude 6. And you have to keep in mind that they are not really big earthquakes, and those higher 5 magnitude earthquakes, they usually do not leave a sign in the atmosphere. With the very strong earthquake in Morocco, we had an obvious atmospheric fluctuation on the 30th of August. That was 9 days prior to the earthquake. So we can count up to 9 days from an atmospheric fluctuation. This time, that was on the 20th, we only had one atmospheric fluctuation, a small one, so I don't expect it to cause really big seismic activity. And that marked regions over Iran and to the south in the Indian Ocean. But again, it was a small fluctuation, pretty weak, so I don't expect it to cause a big earthquake. If I were to estimate when approximately a larger seismic event could occur, approaching magnitude 6, maybe borderline 6, I think that's what we're talking about here, that would be from the 26th to the 28th, most likely. We cannot be really sure, because sometimes when an atmospheric fluctuation occurs, we can have a seismic increase within 1 day. So there is quite some uncertainty there. And again, I don't expect it to be all that much. The Venus-Sun-Mars conjunction on the 25th, that can be a critical conjunction, but there is no convergence with other critical planet conjunctions. There is critical geometry, but they are not conjunctions. So I do expect some seismic increase there, but probably not all that much, probably. Always check out the website for the latest updates, the atmospheric fluctuations and the forecast updates. You can also find more background information, especially on the About page. We have updated the About page. There you can read how and why our research started regarding the planetary positions and seismic activity. Stay safe. Until next time.